Many people know your story, but it's so fascinating. How did you go? Some people don't know this. You were an English major. You studied comparative religion. You're going to be a lawyer. How do you go from that to running a bingo parlor, having $300,000 in debts, and then turning around an entire city? Tell me how did that come about? And more importantly, how do people take their dreams and turn to reality? Because that's what you've done over and over. You take what you've envisioned and you made it real. And most people don't have that skill, or they don't seem to.
You mentioned I was going to be a lawyer.
Yeah.
But at the last minute, I turned away from a life of crime.
Well, that's appropriate after what happened with you today. But tell me.
How do I get from there to there? Well, my dad taught me that what you want to do is stick to simple ideas. And I don't know why, Tony, I don't know where or when, but ever since I was a kid, the idea of building something that would make people go, wow, has struck me as just about the coolest thing in the world to do. Now, it's not saving lives in the real sense or doing something really noteworthy, but it has kept me a happy, happy person. And I always think I got
to build. Too.
Well, I think I got to build another hotel because maybe next time, just maybe, I could get it right. But along the way, we've created 150 or 250,000 jobs. And I think the most satisfaction I've ever gotten has been the fact that the family, the employees, the staffs of the hotels here and abroad, and their families have all sort of merged into one.
Yes.
And we've got this very familial kind of organization, which is very satisfying because I live in the hotels.
Yes.
You know, I'm there every day with my family, and it's a great life.
People there love you, as you well know. I mean, I've talked to them. I go to your hotels, obviously. We're dear friends, but I listen to what they say outside you. And they are always sharing stories about how they've changed lives. You said you don't change lives, but I know you start every meeting in your company with people sharing some way a guest's been touched. Would you share an example of that?
The notion that a single person acting alone without anybody watching, can change the course of an enterprise. It's probably true as much for a company as it is for a country.
I agree.
We believe that, and we have a thing called storytelling. And every day, before every shift starts in every department, the supervisor says in gatherings of 8 to 10 people, anybody got a story about yesterday and something good that happens? And if it's great, we post it on the in-house internet. Yes. And we make signs and a print shop downstairs, and we put up big posters on the walls with the story and a picture of the kid that did it, and they become famous.
Wow.
That is to say, something that they did increases their self-esteem.
Yes.
Anything that increases someone's self-esteem is much more powerful than money.